Hello students, I am Dr. Shantanu Ganguly, the fellow and area convener, Knowledge Management Division of TERI. Today, I am going to talk to you on a very important aspect, and for that which I am extremely thankful to Infibnet for choosing me to talk about this particular module, which is on event planning. This is extremely an important component, not only for the library information centers, but also for any organization to communicate its deliverables. Now, a particular event, failure or a success, it depends completely on how it has been planned. If the planning process is not appropriate, then this event cannot success at all. Whatever money or whatever thing you do, you will not be able to succeed to have a worthwhile, a worthy event on any topic. This module will be able to define the events management, and the events planning in libraries, outline event details for any kind of event, learn to carry out marketing research in event planning, understand the need for planning any future and carry out an event evaluation process. In this module, when I would be talking to you, I'll be taking some examples of an international conference on digital library that is called ICDL, which is a renowned conference in an Asia which brings together a large number of participants, speakers, experts from across the globe. They come to a common platform for a common cause, they debate, they deliberate, and a huge gathering makes the event an extremely successful. The conference started in 2004, we did it in 2006, 2010, and 2013. Every 3 years we have been organizing this event. And in how and why, when, what, where, 5W and 1H concept, we constantly look into or will try to answer or address these when we organize this ICDL event. And I don't call it, being an organizing secretary, I don't call it a successful one, but is the people who say for years together, people wait that when the next ICDL is coming back. So in many instances, I would be giving you an example of ICDL, which I have described in the module, in the written module also. Why to organize an event? In today's dynamic information era, communicating and sharing information and knowledge is an utmost important component. If one does not share or inform his or her knowledge, it will remain dormant forever. In this connection, organizing an event is an important communication tool to reach the unreached. An unique management concept. According to Peter Drucker, one of the management experts, business has only two basic functions, marketing and innovation. Dr. Drucker understands that every business enterprise, whether not for profit or for profit, must carefully research, design, plan, coordinate, and evaluate its marketing strategy to consistently achieve the goals of the enterprise. Event management is a professional field of practice that requires sophisticated skills in strategic planning and analysis, risk assessment, because a lot of risks are involved in it, marketing, budgeting, cash flow planning, event proposal deployment, and many other topics. Measurement within events is the key. It is not possible to evaluate an event or to judge whether it has been a success or not without having set right at the beginning criteria and objectives. Researching stakeholders, clients, delegates, customer requirements, and how to develop an idea into a package and ultimately into a well-designed event should also develop a clear list of objectives. Measurement within events is the key. It is not possible to evaluate an event or to judge whether it has been a success or not without having set right at the beginning criteria and objectives. Researching stakeholders, clients, delegates, customer requirements, and how to develop an idea into a package and ultimately into a well-designed event should also develop a clear list of objectives. There is SMART objectives for events, S-M-A-R-T. If we abbreviate it, S stands for specific to the event, M stands for measurable in statistical terms, A stands for achievable or agreed by those involved, R stands for realistic or relevant to the resources available, and T stands for timed around the event schedule. Now, there are several kinds of events, there are several categories which I have described in the module, and I don't want to go deep into that, but the classifications are like conventions, exposition, seminars, awards presentation, community service award events, symposia, educational and video conferences, receptions, sports and creation programs, political rallies, tours and study missions, and training programs. One of the fundamental thing is event positioning. What type of event is the competition offering? What level of investment are they requiring of their mandates? Who is attending and who is not? What niche are we trying to fill? What makes us different? And how can we seize upon our unique qualities to market our events? And what markets will be receptive to our event concept? Now, for getting an answer to all these questions, you have to do an event research analysis, which is very important. Before one can effectively design and market an event, there is a need to determine the desires, expectations, and anticipations of the audience to whom that marketing will be directed. The event may be an original production or a historical, traditional annual meeting, but research must be an ongoing. By researching markets in depth, the organizing secretary will be able to respond to changing needs as well as to resolve small problems before they become major ones. Quantitative research. A survey questionnaire can be designed to deliberate following questions: potential areas of discussion and debate, contemporary areas which needs more attention during the event, probable speakers of the event, format of the event, event within the events such as parallel sessions, workshop, or side events within the mega event. Quantitative research. What are the objectives of this event? What are the ranges of interest in the markets we are trying to attract? Qualitative research instruments are subjective. Now, for this, event planning strategy is an important component for successfully organizing an event. First, why must we organize the event? So in that case, objectives need to be organized. You have to lay out the objectives, otherwise you cannot organize an event like that. Is that the best way to achieve what we want to achieve? Formats of the event? What are we planning to organize the event? Suitable time, such as month, climatic factor is a very important thing. Like for example, in Delhi, if you see, most of the events takes place in the month of November, December, January, because it's a very pleasant month. Whereas in many of the international countries, in the global countries, where there is a heavy snowfall and all, you cannot organize an event there, because reaching out to those people must be a very problem. Have we agreed it will directly relate to the persons, that is participants level? Where will our event take place? Appropriate location of the event. It is extremely important. We have been organizing for the last 4 ICDL conferences in India Habitat Center only. Why? Because of the centralized location, the vicinity, reaching out for everybody, plus many other accessories which we will be taking one by one. If the place we shall use will provide everything we need, that is the logistics support. Suppose if we are looking at the parallel sessions, we organize number of parallel sessions during ICDL. Do we have all kind of amenities or accessories required for organizing the event in the parallel rooms? Where are our speakers or participants are going to stay? Nearby to the hotels, the guest houses, and many more. How much will organization of the event cost? Event budget breakup is an extremely important. This is a homework. It's a pre-planning stage where you have to come up with this homework. Collect the data and formulate. Where shall we raise the money? Funding opportunities, which I would be taking very differently. Will the media be interested? Media involvement. Because outreach, communication is an extremely important area as far as event is concerned. Will the sponsor be interested in it? USP, unique selling proposition of the event. And how many events of that kind are there? So the competitors of the market. Every time when we organize this international conference on digital library, we have to face the competitions, because there's a large number of digital library conferences and workshops takes place in throughout the world. So it's a very big challenge for us to get participants and speakers. So we have to do a lot of homework for that, or at a pre-planning stage. Now, critical success factors in event are, number one, identify speakers, national and international. Develop and design a marketing promotional strategy. Like for example, database development, virtual platform, websites and social media, printed format. Then comes your participants, national and international. Background paper preparation, theme selection. And finally, funding opportunities, like ministries, bilateral, multilateral organizations, corporates, thematic sponsors, conference sponsors, exhibitions, etc. Now, every time event is not successful, event fails also. Now, why event fails? Many event fails because of wrongly set targets, their type and content, target groups and their interest, what X aspect this event is different from others, what make it exclusive. It will help very much to do the job constructively and systematically. And in the aftermath, the rate will be higher and potential for similar future work brighter. So you have to do a lot, very good homework at a pre-planning stage so that your event is successful. Targets of the event. The targets must be measurable. They should be divided into both qualitative and quantitative. Qualitative targets like satisfaction of participants. Participants come there for many things. For food, for arrangements, for speakers, for interactive platforms. Many things they come for. Reaching out to that particular place and the resource persons. Whereas quantitative targets are number of participants, income, and their expenditure. Now the funding process, because every event completely depends on the funding or the sponsorship. Identification of the source, preparation of the proposal, an extremely important, well-written, thematic-based proposal is required for it. Packaging the benefits for the funders, interaction and presented to the funders, getting the funds and submitting the report. Who are going to be your target organizations and institutions from whom you are going to source the funds? Funding support from government, ministries, government institutions, and autonomous bodies. They can join you or they may join you at different levels. Some joins by giving them as a collaborative role, some as an associate role, some as a knowledge partner, and many more. Or some would give you a seed money to start with the conference jointly with them. Bilateral, multilateral organizations like embassies, cultural organizations, international institutions, corporates like publishers, information service providers, international library service providers. So they, all of them would be approached for the sourcing of the fund. The categories of the fund, it could be different. You have to package it in a more professional way. Like co-organizer, equal status with the organizer. Partner, major stake in the event and active participation. Associates, organization and institutions eager to support the event in different ways with money or in kind. Corporate sponsor strategy. You can have different breakups, different tiers based on their funding status like platinum, gold, silver, bronze and all. Application of marketing mix in an event is an extremely important, and we have been very successful in applying all the, not 4 P's, but 7 P's of marketing. Product, price, place, promotion, people, process, and physical evidence. Let us look at the product. The successful event marketer is at first the consumer of his or her product. The product may be educational program, a country fair, or a full-fledged convention. What is the history of the event? The greatest part of event marketing is the opportunity to create history by attracting people into a synergistic activity that can define the organization and its goals. What is the value of the product? The promise of increasing productivity, maximizing profitability, or simply having a greater time can be legitimate benefits that can persuade a person to buy the product or attend the product. What makes the product unique? Marketers that can identify the return on investment that can be expected by the participants, the special experience that will be offered, and the added value of attendance are those who will successfully market the event. Then comes your price. Market research will illustrate the competition's pricing patterns. Who is offering a similar product to whom and at what price? Price may be secondary or perceived value. It is in this area that even the marketeer can play a major role. Some events are designed to make money pure and simple. Others are strategically developed to break even. financially. You have to do a lot of homework while doing a pricing, because that will also reflect upon your budget allocated for the event. Place, proximity to the potential attendees and ease of travel. Availability of parking for a commuter audience. Ambience and originality of the site. Logistical, practical of staging a particular event. Surrounding attractions, infrastructure for ancillary activities. Degree to which the location fits the character of the event. Safety, security of event attendees. Availability of public transportation like airport, train and local city commutation. Availability of other spaces, meeting rooms, parallel sessions, rooms, secretariat, exhibition, etc. Then comes your another P is promotion. This component plays three vital roles. Providing needed information and advice. Persuading target audience of the merits of a specific product. And encouraging them to take action at specific times. Public relations, some tools of the event in event public relations are like media releases, that is the news oriented, publicity releases, promotionally oriented, media kits including photographs, biographies, press releases, brochures, organizational fact sheets, schedules, speakers, backgrounds and topics, mission statements, ancillary activities, phone fax and email information for contacts, radio and TV spots releases, copies of speeches, videotapes, audio tapes, etc. So these are basically some of the tools which are related for the promotional purpose. Where in the promotion, with the current information and communication technology, internet plays a very, very important role. You can create a separate website. You can have an interactive platform in Facebook. Another interactive platform could be LinkedIn. You can put some past videos in the YouTubes. Online advertising you can come up on payment basis. You can get in touch with some of the listservs to have a group of community comes to know about your event. Email marketing, which is very aggressively you can do repeatedly without any cost. And then the most important thing in current scenario is mobile marketing. You can develop apps, you can develop a different kind of mobile based different short messages to sensitize the people about the event. Then comes your people. People services depend on direct personal interactions between audience and the organization and the organization secretary. The nature of this interaction strongly influences the audience perception of service quality. Customers often judge the quality of the event service they receive largely on their assessment of the people providing the service. Process, creating and delivering product elements to customer requires the design and implementation of effective process. Poor process make it difficult for frontline staff to do their jobs well, result in low productivity and increase the likelihood of service failures. Let us take an example. You are responding to somebody your queries on an event. If your process is not well defined, you may not be able to respond back to him. So ultimately what happens? You lose your client for your event. So process has to be well defined. Physical evidence, appearance of event venue, landscaping, logistics arrangements, team members, printed materials and other visible cues, all providing tangible evidence of your organization's service style and quality. Lot of due diligence has to be done as far as the physical evidence is concerned. You have to locate an appropriate place, its arrangements, its logistical arrangements for getting an event. We have been trying to organize this ICDL in other parts of the country. We are unable to. Because of several reasons, But the most important thing is that for the last 4 ICDLs, we have been organizing it at India Habitat Center, which gives us a lot of impetus to it. It is within Terry and all my people, all the resources, all the things which are necessary for event planning management, they are all at one place. So that's so important. So logistics management, getting the right things to the right places at the right time for the right cost. As far as event is concerned, these days you have also to take into consideration when you are organizing a big event, especially a convention or an international conference, something related to health, safety and risk assessment. Identify the hazards. Determine who is at risk. Determine if the existing controls are adequate and amend accordingly. Record the findings and review the assessment as necessary. If you do that, it would be very easy for you to repeat some of the existing participants to come again and again and again for the conferences and events. So event evaluation process, clearly define the evaluation criteria for the event. Design an evaluation process. It could be formal, it could be informal. Feedback from the client, feedback from participants, visitors, etc. Feedback from the event management team, individuals. Identify appropriate sources of information data for evaluation. Evaluation and monitoring, summative at the end of the event, and formative considered throughout the event process. So event management is the coordination, running and planning of all the people, your teams and the features that comes together to create every kind of event. Defining event objectives at the very start of event planning is very important as it gives the direction in which organizers should proceed to accomplish the laid out objectives. Organizing an event without clear objective is a huge waste of time and resources. The number of people involved in organizing an event depends upon the size and the scale of the event. The event report usually contains having information related to seating and light arrangements, promotional materials used, blueprint of the whole venue, program and food venue, contact details of the sponsors, partners, clients for whom the event is organized, and the service providers. So, I'm sure with the help of this module, and in the module itself, I have given you a checklist which will help you to meticulously examine each and every component to organize a successful event in the field of library and information center.